Hi, everybody. Welcome back to our family room.
Well, tonight's selection is the song The Heather on the Hill from the 1947 musical Brigadoon, which I guess is kind of an obscure musical now, but it's by the songwriting theater team of Alan J. Lerner and Frederick Loewe. And Lerner and Loewe, of course, went on to have a gigantic hit with My Fair Lady some years later. And they went on to do Camelot, and the film of Gigi was successful. Paint Your Wagon was maybe a lesser hit. I was realizing that I've actually performed in all these shows, all these Lerner and Loewe shows, and I really like them all, but Brigadoon is my favorite. It's the one that really first put them on the map in 1947. Rodgers and Hammerstein had just kind of started this fire of how to do a musical play. And Lerner and Loewe just caught it. They figured it out, and they really did it right with Brigadoon. And the response in New York on Broadway when it opened was electric.
Mm-hmm. It played at the Ziegfeld Theater. I think it ran for over 500 performances originally, and Agnes DeMille is one of the choreographers, won a Tony Award. Most people know the movie with Gene Kelly,
Sid Charisse, Van Johnson,
directed by Vincent Minnelli. That's how a lot of people know this.
Yeah, and I think it's a different kind of treatment of the story because it became a Gene Kelly vehicle, which is not really what the original show was about. It became this kind of breezy singing in the rain style kind of a show. It's well made and the people are so talented in it. But the story really has to do with faith, actually. It's these two Americans who head out from New York City to the highlands of Scotland, and they get lost and they find this little hamlet in the highlands of Scotland that appears in the mists called Brigadoon. And it's strange at first because everything seems to be from 200 years ago. Well, it turns out it really is 200 years ago. This town, the little town minister has prayed for a miracle, which has been granted by God. And now this whole village every night vanishes into the mists. And when they wake up, the villagers, the next morning, it's 100 years later. And so it's been 2 days since the miracle was granted. And it just happens to be the day that these two Americans stumble into this town. And of course, our American meets a Scottish lassie and begins to fall in love. And the story is about the faith that he's going to require to believe in this miracle too if he wants to stay with her and join this magical place in the Highlands, or whether it's just too much to believe. And this song, The Heather on the Hill, is their meeting song, their charm song, as they get to know each other. Tommy meets Fiona, and Fiona's younger sister is about to get married later that afternoon, and they go on the hillside to pick heather for the wedding.
Here it is.
Can't we two go walking together out beyond the valley of trees? Out where there's a hillside of heather curtsying gently in the breeze. That's what I like to do, see the heather, but with the mist of May's in the gloaming, and all the clouds are holding still. So take my hand and let's go roaming through the heather on the hill. The morning dew is blinking yonder, there's lazy music in the rill, and all I want to do is wander heather on the hill. There may be other days as rich and rare, there may be other springs as full and fair, but they won't be the same, they'll come and go. For this I know, that when the mist is in the gloaming and all the clouds are holding still, if you're not there, I won't go roaming through the heather on the hill. The heather on the hill.
Well, it almost sounded like I was trying to woo you, didn't it?
There's a difference between wooing and just being sentimental because you're tired.
that what I'm being? Sentimental because I'm tired?
I believe so. But 'tis very agreeable.
Still,
I won't go roaming
through the heather.